Now, I have reasons to believe why it was constructed, and it was for reasons other than convincing people that anarchism or voluntarism is a good thing, but I could save that to a later video if people are interested.
One eternity later.
I've done a lot of videos and podcasts over the years about defooing, but I've never done an all-encompassing dive into the topic explaining what it is and what's wrong with it. I've done videos responding to people's misunderstandings or misrepresentations of it, but nothing for the people who weren't already in the wheelhouse of Stefan Molyneux criticism. So here we are. So let's start off with the basics, dig into its roots, find out what it's become, and what is so dangerous about it. Now, foo has nothing to do with Dave Grohl, so I'm sorry to upset my 90s nostalgic pals. Foo is an acronym for family of origin. It means the family to which you were born into or raised into. This is a common term in therapy, and Molyneux got the idea from his wife, who is a real practicing mental health counselor in Mississauga, Canada. In fact, most people don't know this about Free Domain Radio. It didn't start on his website. It started on a message board on his wife's old website, and the topics usually centered not around philosophy, libertarianism, or current events, but it was really all about therapy. Now, defooing is a term coined by Molyneux meaning to disassociate oneself from their family of origin, hence defoo. Molyneux says that no relationship in your life is involuntary, and because they are voluntary, you may discard them as you see fit, specifically family members who are abusive, asterisk, but only after speaking to a professional counselor, asterisk. And I will qualify those asterisks later on in the video, but for now, let's just move on. Disassociation of family members is not something alien to therapy. If there's people who physically, sexually, or emotionally abused you in your life, and they make no attempt to apologize, rectify, or put an end to that behavior, you'd be really hard-pressed to find any mental health professional to recommend preserving that relationship. I would disagree with anyone who would object to this practice. I would also be hard-pressed to find anyone who is reasonable who would object to this practice. In the late 80s and early 90s, a philosopher and theologian by the name of John Bradshaw thrusted this topic into the limelight again when he started speaking out against abusive upbringings and told people that they can create new families for themselves who do care for you and can offer the support that your foo could not. Now, if this was Molyneux's position, that would be great, but it's not that simple. Defooing, unlike classic therapy ethical standards, and John Bradshaw mentioned earlier, isn't about cutting ties with everyone you know. Molyneux is about cutting ties with everyone you know, in practice. You see, though Molyneux is very clear that he's only talking about abusive people, he has a very big tent for what he defines as abuse. Were you ever spanked? Well, your mother can never be forgiven. Did you go to Sunday school? Well, you might as well have been beaten bloody.
Religious instruction will, without a doubt, without a shred of a doubt, be viewed as child abuse. And I don't even need to go into why. I've done it a number of times before, but of all the things, right?
Did your parents send you to public school? Well, your dad might as well have been Joseph Fritzl.
Now, what about public schools? It's hard to imagine that public schools would not be viewed as abusive in the future. I mean, it's impossible to imagine. Even if we take out the more extreme things like constant drugging of children to get them to conform to an entirely unnatural life, where they get a great deal of stimulation and entertainment outside of school, right, when they have video games and TV shows catered to their needs and great toys and all that. So that compared to what is actually occurring in the public schools, which is just grindingly dull and repetitive and boring and punitive and aggressive and scary and all that, cliquey and all that kind of crap. So it's hard to imagine that, it's impossible to imagine, for me at least, that in the future people will not look at public schools.
Did they vote for McCain or Obama in 2008? Well, they want you shot.
Somebody says, I support farm subsidies. You simply say to them, do you support me getting shot if I don't support them? I think we need socialized medicine. Will you support me getting shot if I don't agree? Or thrown into an ass-raping, gang-bang, hellish prison hole? Do you support torture or violence against me if I disagree with you? We need old age security. Will you shoot me if I disagree? Yes or no? It's a yes or no question. Will you support me getting shot if I disagree? Do you advocate the use of violence against me if I disagree with you? You don't keep people in your life who want you shot. You don't hang with people who want you shot. You don't go to dinner parties with people who want you shot.
Did your dad buy some Nike shoes? Well, get that butthole ready.
You know, if you want, say, Nike to not have a cop-hating guy like Colin Kaepernick be the poster boy for their Just Do It campaign, then obviously you give your Nike shoes to the homeless people, and then you if someone in your friendships, your families or whatever has the Nike shoes, you sit down, talk with them and say, this is like horribly offensive, this is nasty, do you see what they're doing? You just talk to people, and then if it's some friend or acquaintance and they're like, you get into this and they won't change their mind based on reason and evidence, you cut them the hell out of your life.
Sounds like someone wants to get raped again.
See, you may not have noticed that you were abused, but your brain did. And look, we can get into all of the reasons why spanking and public schooling are terrible things for kids and their upbringing, and I'd be inclined to agree with you on all of them. But I won't agree with you is the severity that Molyneux emphasizes. Spanking is detrimental to a child's upbringing. Sure, it's not an unforgivable sin, nor is it comparable to getting beaten. I'm sure any sane and reasonable person will agree with me that the political differences aren't abusive either. But Molyneux is insane.
But I remember being in the backseat of the car and dozing, and wave after wave after wave after wave of just unbelievably violent images occurred to me, where I was literally smashing my mother's head open like a watermelon with a baseball bat, and I hated it. I hated it. It was so violent, and it kept recurring, and it kept recurring until I just said, fuck it, you know, I'm just tired of fighting all this stuff, and I just embraced it. It's like, okay, give me two baseball bats. Have her come back to life. I'm going to knock her head off again.
Now, I already made a video about the objection that would come after that last statement, but what about the against me argument? And I'll put a link in the description and a card right here in case you want to check that out later, and why it does not hold any water whatsoever. Despite Molyneux claiming that defooing is just a very small topic for Free Domain Radio,
the other thing to remember is that I don't have a lot of shows about this. I've done 3,000 shows, of which 3 or 4 have been me talking about this topic.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So this is not any kind of central focus of what it is. It's just if people ask me where the principles apply, I have to say where I think the principles apply, and I have to provide my arguments.
This is a topic that gets a lot of attention on this podcast. I'll leave another link in the description and the card here to see how big of a topic it really is despite this claim. Claim. No, I take that back. That's too charitable. This is a bald-faced lie, and he knows it.
It's a lot easier to get people's agreement on abstract philosophical principles than it is on personal relationships, particularly core ones or foundational ones like family relationships. So I needed to start talking about gods and government, because if I'd started off about family, then I wouldn't have gotten anywhere with anyone, right? But the hook, I guess there's a hook, right? And the bait on the hook is, hey, let's talk philosophy, let's talk the state, let's talk about God, and so on. And let's talk about abstract power structures, and let's work out a philosophical approach that is logical and consistent with those abstract power structures. And people love to come along with that because it's interesting, it's thrilling, it's exciting, it gives you great debating points, it, you know, wakens up your brain and so on. And I needed to get people's confidence or trust that I had something useful to offer, something of consistency and rigor to offer in those areas, to get them swept up, to get them excited, to stimulate their minds and so on. I needed to do all of that and to get people swept up in the thrill of abstract philosophy. And then, you know, when they're on board and we're out of sight of land, and then I can say where we're really going, which is we're not sailing into an abstract world of futuristic societies with DROs and private defense agencies and so on. What we're sailing towards is your family and your life and your friends. We're not sailing into an abstract future that you can only guess at and talk about and theorize. And the real question here is not whether there will be vending machines with cocaine in a free society in 200 years. The real question is, if these are your values, what are you going to do about your relationship where you really have control and power? If we're going to ask people to give up the state, but we won't give up our friends, if we're going to ask people to give up their subsidies, like the farmers or the military, if we're going to ask people to give up their subsidies, but we hang around corrupt parents because they're paying for our university, it's just hypocrisy.
So Molyneux says to Joe Rogan, oh no, it's just a small little topic. It hardly ever gets brought up. Bullshit. But he knows that the entire point of Free Domain Radio to begin with is to get people in with topics like politics, philosophy, and current events, etc., just so that he can get them onto the topic that he thinks is really important. Cutting ties with everyone you know who isn't a Molyneuxian. Now, back in the day, and mind you, this is internet time, so it was like a few months ago, Molyneux had a web forum that's now deleted. On this forum, people would brag about how they defooed their family, and other members of the board would come in and praise them for doing so, often for some benign reasons. His call-in show is littered with people wanting to call in to debate him on things like economics or philosophy, and he would immediately turn the conversation into, how many times were you spanked, and try to get them to cut ties with their family.
Can I ask you a question?
Yeah, sure.
What was your infancy and toddlerhood like?
Grew up in a very good household. Was Catholic, but very peaceful and very loving. But I think
and
my
how
overall.
How were you disciplined as a child?
I was spanked here and there.
And how often were you spanked?
3.7 times a week. No, I don't know. Very rarely, few and far between. Maybe once a month, twice a month. I mean, this isn't too pertinent to what I wanted to talk about, but we can get into it.
No, it's extremely pertinent. And the reason I'm asking, look, you don't have to answer any of this, of course, right? I mean, if you've probably heard, I have a theory, right, about why people are drawn towards a resource-based economy. And I don't know if you've heard the theory. It doesn't really matter if you have or not. But it's important for me to get the information. You certainly don't have to provide any of it. But there's a reason why I'm asking, which is not to try and poke holes in your family history, but just to try and understand why somebody might be drawn to a resource-based economy. All right? Well, I won't push that then. I think everyone can judge for themselves the quality of a relationship like that. It involves hitting and deception and avoidance and so on.
Look, I hate the Zeitgeist movement as much as the next Lulbert, but not enough to convince them to cut ties with everyone they know. That's just fucked up. He says that when the pressure is on him about this topic, and there's plenty of times where he gives this advice without such caveats.
You don't hang with people who want you shot.
Get into this and they won't change their mind based on reason and evidence. You cut them the hell out of your life.
You will be ostracized, I said, wrote to this gentleman. You will be you will be ostracized by your family for not going to see your grandfather. This is painful, of course, but it is a big plus, since you can, in one fell swoop, get rid of all of the bad people in your life.
So no, this is a PR line that he uses when he gets his hand caught in the cookie jar. Now, am I saying that blood is thicker than water and that you should never cut ties with anyone, even if they rape you constantly? And am I saying that all family members are good and you should always do everything that you can to keep them close, even if they hospitalize you every week? Yes. Yes, I am. No, of course not. That's not what I'm saying. What a fucking stupid thing to say. Only a retard would walk away from this video thinking that I said that. What I'm saying is just because that your mom voted for Hillary or that you had to go to public school, these aren't sound reasons why you should never talk to them again. And if they do actual physical, emotional, psychological, or sexual harm to you, seek a professional counselor first and advise their counsel. Not just to get a second opinion, but to deal with the harm that can come from such abuse. Don't listen to some internet blowhard with the podcast when it comes to your medical or psychological well-being. Anyways, I will talk to you guys later. Worms. I want to thank FDR Liberated for the resources to make this video. There's lots of great information on that site about Molyneux, and I would recommend everybody to swing on by and have a look at what they have to say. I'll leave a link in the description.